Hello guys, my name is Aurora and I'm a part of the Forex Strategies Resources team. In this video, I will show you an effective day trading and swing strategy based on a regression deviated channel. The past regression deviated method is a strategy that develops from the Gymo method. The basic idea is that when the price is far from the center line of the regression, it tends to return there. Its red line can be regarded as strong overbought, oversold levels. The behavior is similar to that of the other oscillators such as stochastic, RSI and CCI when they reverse after reaching the extreme of the bands. This trading system is very profitable. The rules are easy to follow and requires only a few indicators. This strategy is easily replicable on all trading platforms because it is based on indicators available in any language. In the following image, I show you the setting of the strategy. Trading rules. Buy. Entry when a candle H1 closes between the lower red line and the lower orange line of the indicator TRD. Wait for a subsequent one to close above the lower upper orange line. Usually, at this point, the CCI indicator coming from below crosses its minus 100 line, providing the signal for the buy entrance. Sell. When a candle H1 closes between the highest red line and the upper orange line of the indicator PRD, wait for a subsequent one to close below the upper lower orange line. Usually, at this point, the CCI indicator coming from above crosses its plus 100 line, providing the signal for the sell entrance. Exit from the position, buy or sell. The rule is really simple. If the conditions for a sell input are met, see above, it must exit from a buy position. Conversely, if the conditions for a buy entry are met, see above, you must exit a position sell. Scalping trading rules. It is also possible to use the PRD indicator to do scalping. When the price hits the upper red line, you enter sell. When it hits the bottom red line, you enter buy. I have not tried, but even in a 1 hour H1 chart, there are many trades that give small gains. This also allows for better inputs when the scalping signal is confirmed when the trading signal crosses the orange line. It would also be interesting to try scalping on lower time frames. Example trades. The first entry signal, buy 1 and char 1, was a buy at 10 a.m. on April 28. The admission price was 139.45, including the spread. The stop loss that would have been on the red line at the 138.83 level was too tight and therefore was set at 138.55. The first partial close occurred at 30 p.m. when the price reached the yellow line at 140.16. At this point, I wanted to close my first position with a profit of 71 pips. After that I moved at the stop loss of the remaining position on the lowest orange line, or I blocked it 10 pips away, depending on how it looks best. The lowest orange line was at 139.17 and so I moved the stop at 139.55. to freeze it at 10 pips. The exit signal came at 7 p.m. when the bid was at 114.93. It is indicated by the writing sell 1. The second one trade was closed with a profit of 148 pips. If you make 3 trades, the second exit is when the price hits the red line at 141.85 with a profit of 240 pips. The third trade was then closed with a profit of 148 at the first useful signal. After this first phase, I placed a sell order for a trade at 140.93 with a stop loss at 141.95. This trade was a loss of 102 pips. The next signal was a buy 2, which occurred at 6 p.m. on April 13th. The admission price was at 145.92 with a stop loss at 144.75 according to the red line. The trade closed on the next sell signal when the price was at 146.07 for a profit of 15 pips. The sell signal at 8 p.m. on April 13th was at the price of 146.07 with a stop loss at 146.96. The trade has closed with the next signal at 2 a.m. on May 1st by 3. Then the ask was 145.94. The profit on this trade was 13 pips. The next buy signal, buy 3, was at the price of 145.94 with a possible stop loss at 145.55. However, it was considered too tight and so was set at 145.4 when the price hit the line. Central yellow at 146.59, the first half of the trade was closed for 63 pips of a profit and the stop loss was moved to 146.4. The second half of the trade was stopped with 10 pips of a profit. At 6 a.m. on May 1st, there was a buy signal by 4 at the price of 146.18 with a stop loss at 145.71. It was still considered too tight and was set at 155.28. When the price reached the median just before the opening of the European session, the first half was closed at 146.85 with a profit of 67 and the stop loss was moved to 146.28. After a very large movement of the price, the stop loss was brought to 147.21, about half below the long candle. The trade has closed at sell 6 on the chart with a profit of 181 pips for the second half of the trade. A buy at 9 a.m. on May 6, by 6, the entry price was 147.77 with a stop loss on the red line at 147.6. However, it was set at 146.87. At 12 a.m. it closed half position at 148.53 for a profit of 88 pips and the stop loss was raised to 147.50. At 4 a.m. on the 7th May, the zero stop loss was moved to 148 0.59. The trade was stopped before the price went up again. For a final release at 3 p.m. on May 7th, when the price was 149.90 for a pleasant profit of 213. The next trade sell signal was picked up at 149.90 with a stop loss at 150.87. At 6 p.m. the price reached the yellow median and therefore closed a position at 148.83 for a profit of 107 pips. The stop loss was then moved over the to 149.80. At 7 a.m. on 8 May, the stop was moved further to 149.25. And the trade was stopped a few hours late for a profit of 65 pips. The chart showing the entire period of this study. The first six cells were against trend. The next two cells occurred during a side market and the final ones during a downtrend. The first buy trade occurred during reversal trend. The next three during an uptrend. Others two during a side market and the final four were against trend. Total pips from April 28 to May 13, 2 weeks, equal 90.59 with 50 gains and 4 losses. Subscribe, like and share this video.